Good morning, everyone. I'm here to present a case report of bilateral painless sudden loss of vision in a case of preeclampsia. This is a 28-year-old primary with preeclampsia, underwent cesarean section and has given birth to healthy twin girls. Then she has complained sudden painless bilateral loss of vision associated with headache on her post-operative day one. There's no history of altered mental status, seizures or loss of consciousness. She was then started on conservative management. On examination, the blood pressure was 150 by 100 under medication on her post-operative day one. On systemic examinations, there was no abnormality detected. On bedside ocular examination, the visual acuity was PL positive in both the eyes, with anterior segment, extraocular movements and pupils being normal. And on dilated fundoscopy, the mydriasis was good and the fundus was normal with no hemorrhages or cotton wool spots. With the normal fundus picture, to rule out the other causes of blindness in a young postpartum patient with history of preeclampsia, the MRI was done. On MRI brain, multiple cortical and subcortical white matter hyperintensities in bilateral cerebral hemispheres, predominantly in parietal, temporal and occipital lobes and bilateral cerebellar hemispheres are seen. This is most likely suggestive of posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome. On her post-operative day 4, we have reviewed her back in ophthalmology OPD with reports. By then, the vision was counting finger close to face in both the eyes, with pupil anterior segment and fundus being normal. And again, the patient was reviewed after discharge on day 10. By then, the visual acuity was improved to 6 by 9 in both the eyes, and N6 and color vision was also normal. The patient denied for HVF perimetry and check MRI. Coming to the discussion part, posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome, it's a reversible neurological entity. It is characterized by headache, visual disturbances, altered mental status, seizures, and unconsciousness. It is associated with multiple conditions, but preeclampsia, eclampsia being the most common. We have different theories, of which cerebral vasoconstriction in response to acute hypertension is the most widely accepted one. And the other theories are vasogenic edema as a result of hyperperfusion and toxins, which can cause endothelial injury and disrupt the blood-brain barrier. And also activation of cellular immune system that accompanies vasoconstriction contributes to delayed hypoperfusion and edema. Hemianopia, visual neglect, auras, visual hallucinations and cortical blindness are the different visual abnormalities we can encounter. MRI being the gold standard, we have typical lesions in posterior subcortical white matter, especially in the occipital and parietal lobes of the brain. The treatment is mostly conservative with control of hypertension and prevention or treatment of seizures and termination of pregnancy when necessary. The prognosis is usually good for these patients when we have timely diagnosis and timely control of hypertension.
That was really good, Shibya. Now I have got just two questions for you. See, so many people are undergoing normal delivery or cesarean sections.
Yes,
and they are completing their term also. Is there any, and they might be hypertensive also.
Yes, sir.
Is there any way to just gauge that these patients may land up into this type of problem prior to, can we have some guidelines for these patients that whom will land into this or who may go into this severe condition of bilateral visual loss?
So like you are asking me prior to the delivery?
Yeah. In the third term, when the patient is about to deliver, now the last week is going on. So can we have some indicator that this patient might land up into this type of problem, or there is no such indicator?
No, sir. As far as I have searched, I didn't get any such indication. It is just given that once when we are evaluating the patient, along with the normal conditions which are associated with the eclampsia vision loss like retinal detachment or hypertensive retinopathy, we also have to consider these syndromes which are reversible, but when we give only timely treatment.
No positive finding as such in the eyes or except the MRI finding, there is nothing to suggest the patient had this problem. Did you ever consider doing a visual ego potential on this patient to see the reason for a loss of vision?
As your the vision was just PL positive only.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
With that quantum of vision loss.
Yes, sir. We have considered, but the neurologist has said it's not necessary, so we didn't.
They believe it will come back.
My worry is like, how do you make sure this patient was, except for the MRI finding? MRI finding can be a red herring, okay, you found that, but whether the patient was not, what do you call it, malingering?
That's quite a possibility, sir, but VEP we have considered for sure, but neurologist has said that is not necessary. Let's first see the MRI, then we can decide accordingly.
And I hope your pupil was both NSNR. Yeah, yeah. Pupil was absolutely all right. Yeah,
yeah. Yes,
sir. So then it becomes really difficult to say. Matab.
Yes, sir. But for the cortical blindness, sir, as we know, pupils will be normal and also the fundus is normal despite
That's what he was asking. Then yes, is there any other method to gauge that whether the things are going in right direction, whether she's not malingering or something like that?
So for that, we have to rule out with the other malingering test.
Okay. Nicely done. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.